Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 4 of Direwolf20's Forgecraft 2 series. I'm killing Enderman. See you later, Enderman. Oh no, I've become what I hate most. Don, 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 dire Enderman. That's okay.
Hello.
We can remedy that. What's up, Soren?
Dreaming.
I've got 2 Ender Pearls. So I think I really just need one more at this point. What you should probably be thinking is, why does Dire want 3 Ender Pearls? That's a very good question. I'm glad you asked. It's because I want to start collecting lava. And then, I think Soren and I just had a little conversation regarding how... Ooh, I see an Enderman in the distance. Come here, buddy. I'm looking at you. You should get angry and come over here. And then give me an Ender Pearl. How's it going? There you go. Got your attention. Endermen are the best because you can see them like 100 blocks away and they'll be like, ah, I'll come right over. I will come and die. I found something that I want.
This looks weird.
Dire pig does the things that a dire pig does.
And we got that on video and stream.
Oh, yes. Maybe I shouldn't be fighting 3 skeletons in third-person view, but they die so easily. Alright. Hello, dire pig. Alright, I need to be full-size for a minute. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. I really, really like how smoothly your camera angle changes and everything when you shapeshift. Like, even in first-person, it's like, no problem.
Yeah.
So what were we talking about just a minute ago before I got excited by Dire Pig?
I'm about to die to a baby zombie?
I don't think I said anything about you dying to a baby zombie. You suffocated in a wall, though.
I placed a book above my head.
Oh, Soren. Soren's really having fun being small.
I like being the book. Linking books are fun.
Soren found that you can morph into a linking book, and it gets you, like, super tiny.
And you get into smaller spaces, so... Basically have multi-parts.
Yes. Ah! Skeleton Eddie's Iron Mine
Tree. Eddie's house is filled with those little multi-part passages now.
Alright, guys, so what I'm gonna do is look around for a few more Endermen as the night wanes, and then... off to do cool and exciting adventures. I want to get, and this is probably going to be a multi-part episode here, so it's going to take more than just one episode to get done everything that I have in mind. But very much would like to... Oh, pigs, I'm getting stuff. I want to get to a workshop. That's usually the thing I like to do if I manage to be one of the first players to start in the world. Like, I didn't do a workshop really early on last season because the world existed for a while before I jumped into it. So there was really no point to a workshop because a lot of people already existed on the server and didn't need a workshop. But at this point, we're still pretty low tech for a lot of people, so I think my goal should be to tech up as fast as possible, and then other players who haven't gotten to that tech level yet will be able to jump over to the workshop. And I think what we're going to do this time around, a little bit different than usual, is combine some ages into one. I'm thinking a 3-point age of Digger, Workshop, and Nexus. So you'll be able to bring your books by, act as a Nexus, use the workshop for doing whatever you want, and then if you want, you can go outside and just do some digging in Digger. I'll make sure people don't actually place quarries right outside the front door, because, like, surprisingly, cool. I have to sometimes tell people about that. Like, hey, don't put quarries right outside the front door. That would be nice. Thanks, bro. But, unfortunately, I have to say that, so I'm going to have to say that. I'll put up a sign. Like, please be smart about where you place your quarries. But for now, running around. Do I already have cow? I'm pretty sure I have cow. I don't know. We're about to find out.
I don't think that magnum
I don't have cow.
Working.
And I do now, though. I am cow. I really, really enjoy the morph mod. All right, guys. Looks like it's getting daytime, so let me make my way home. And I will catch you guys back at the main base. Where, wow, I have a lot of arrows in me. Awesome. All right. Be right back. All right, we are back, guys, and I'm making my first endothermic pump. Now, this is a brand new item that you guys haven't really seen before. Unless, of course, you watched my spotlight on Extra Utilities. It comes from the Extra Utilities mod. Extra Utilities adds a bunch of cool stuff. Where is it here? There it is. See, look at all the cool stuff Extra Utilities adds. It's awesome. Basically, what this one in particular does is the following. It allows you to pump up lava, and it replaces the lava with... whatchamacallit, some cool stuff called cobblestone. Yay, very exciting, right? What's exciting about that is, number one, it doesn't really leave flowing lava blocks behind, so it kind of does a nice job of keeping itself tidied up. Number two, I'm pretty sure it also forcibly chunk loads everything within range, so it'll make sure that it keeps the area nearby chunk loaded, which is a pretty good deal. So let's see, do I have the stuff to make it? I do not. What am I missing? I've got the Eye of Ender. Come on, you... Did I make the iron pickaxe? Yes, obsidian. Oh, I know. I need a bucket of lava. So pretty soon, Amnet, you're not going to have to manually refill this lava tank anymore, which you've kindly been doing for us. I bet that's exciting news. All right. I totally have everything I need. Uh-huh. You. Eye of Ender. This thing. Some other stuff, and a diamond. There we go. Endothermic pump. Cool. The next thing I want to work on is the following. You know, it takes a lot longer to craft things when you don't have an AE system doing it for you?
Mm-hmm.
Kind of missing that already. Ender tank. Very first one. We're going to need some wool. That's the only thing we're missing. Mob drops, I think, is where I would keep wool or string. Am I keeping string somewhere else, or do we just not have that much string?
I don't think we have that much.
Maybe we should plant some cotton.
You need an electric jetpack to make a quantum suit. Because I think you can fly with a quantum suit.
What?
I'm just looking at recipes in ICT.
Oh, okay.
It requires an electric jetpack.
So we have a lot of roses, I presume, but do we have any... Oh, we do have one flower. Nice. We're going to need more flowers, the yellow kind. How's yellow, yellow, red sound for our lava bucket?
Here.
I just did that. So let's go give it a try. Oh, you know what we're going to need otherwise? That should probably be enough. I'm going to need that. I'm going to need that. I'm going to need a little bit of redstone. Cobble. Glass. A little bit more glass.
You're following the Vanny Wild and it. Watch as he moves in his habitat.
What's happening now? Things?
I'm following Amnet into his natural habitat.
Oh. Gonna need some redstone engines to power this nifty little gadget. Four of you. You know what? I need eight.
I wish I could right click on something and automatically follow my camera to it.
Alright, four redstone engines, and let's get some, I guess levers would do, right? Levers will probably be fine. I mean, it's already episode 4, I better be crafting levers. Otherwise, it's not really Direwolf's Let's Play series, is it?
No, not really.
Alright, I hear spider, which is a bad thing. That's a lot of spiders. Dude, these M-Dio spiders are nasty. Way to go, Ghast, in the middle of a lava lake. Why are you down there? It's a terrible place for him to be.
Ow. That's sad and horrible.
Alright, let me deal with this ghast, guys, and then I'll be right back. Alright, guys, I eventually gave up on fighting that stupid ghast, and I'm coming down here, because I know there's a relatively, I'm not going to say safe, but semi-safe area. So let's see if I remember how exactly this works. Really, dude? Come on, man. The ghast, like, found me down here.
Well, he's hunting you. He's hunting the dire. Sorry. I just passed myself.
That's creepy.
Mm-hmm. Right, I have gone to find myself. If I return before I come back, please.
Alright guys, I think I'm ready to try this thing out. So I'm pretty sure what we can do is place the endothermic pump over stone. It has to be placed just above the lava level. So like you have to place it one block above where all the lava is. You can't place it like on top of this block. Like you couldn't put it here. That wouldn't work. But one level above, it should be okay. We're going to find out though. So let's get some redstone engines and we'll get a tank going here.
Are you still hitting things, Andrew? I thought this place was on for... Whoa! Baby villager zombie! Nope.
Okay, so there's that.
And then I hate you.
And that. So let's see if we start getting some lava here in a moment.
Alright
guys, we're back. It turns out that, what's that, Soren?
I thought explosions was removed.
I'll have to ask CBW, because I'm not really sure now. Long story short, we needed to not use redstone engines, and it started working. As a matter of fact, I even heated up the redstone engines using the Stirling engine, and, yeah. They just instantly cooled down to blue, so that didn't work out so well. But, hey, the good news is it worked. So that's cool. I guess it replaces it with smooth stone now. Neat.
Hmm.
I pinged him on IRC already. But, hey, we've got a tank here.
Oh, I thought he was still in game. Okay. Yeah.
Cool. So we've got one side of a tank. Let's go see if we can get some more enderpearls, Soren. Maybe it'll be nighttime in the overworld. Maybe it won't be.
Way to go. You jinxed it.
I did. It's almost nighttime, though. All right, guys, we'll be back. All right, guys, we're back. As you know, many of us like to... Hello, me.
Hello.
I wonder who's pretending to be me.
I think it's Amnet.
Yeah, it's probably Amnet. So what's your skin then, Soren? Oh, now we're all me. Hooray. That's interesting. Is it rendering on him? Because, I don't know. Okay. Anyway, as you guys know, we typically like to make a Mistcraft Age for digging in. It's called Digger. I think what I'd like to do this time around, though, is actually include that as part of the Nexus and for the Machine Workshop. So what we'll do is we'll create a Digger Age, and where you land in the Digger Age will be the center of the workshop. Cool. So, I spawned in some creative notebooks, obviously, because we don't have any Mistcraft stuff yet. These will only be used to create the Digger Age, because this will prevent people from quarrying in the overworld. It's just basically a good idea, and it's helpful for the server overall, in terms of tick rate, and, you know, just long story short, we need to do it. It's something we always do. So I'm going to do it now. Cool. So I guess we get to choose our biomes. Do we have any particular biomes? Usually we were doing like mountain biomes, but I'm not a fan of that. I think I want to just do like a simple plains biome. And if somebody wants to make their own, like, you know, extreme hills or whatever so that they can get emeralds, then that's on them. I think I'm just going to do simple plains biome. Does that sound like a plan?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there's two plains biomes. Probably one of them is BOPs. Look out, it fires really fast. All right. Soren's now something. So how about just like a simple, do we want plains? I think plains is probably good. Or do we want
good.
Or do we want desert, because then it won't rain?
Desert would be optimal, yeah.
What's
I
that?
Like deserts. Deserts.
Yeah, desert?
Yeah.
So, I don't know which one of these two desert biomes is the vanilla one, so I'll just go with the first one. Sure, why not? You have to tell me, by the way, I'm very excited by XCOMP adding creative notebooks that have separate pages in them. That's pretty awesome.
What do you mean?
He added creative notebooks, like one for each type. He has one that has all symbols in it, but then he has one with like different types. All right, so that's a single biome. desert biome. We're going to want a normal moon, normal stars, normal sun. I'm not going to make this an eternal day. Twinkling stars, eh? I don't know what that means, but it sounds cool. I think I'm going to go with that, twinkling stars, just because I don't know what it is, and I like the idea of it.
Mnet, is there an easy way to get the ingredients for the darts? Thorns is the only one I don't know how to get. Can I plant those?
Normal lighting. We'll probably want caves and ravines. We don't want anything else. We're going to want deep lakes, dungeons, sure. Huge trees, no. Mine shafts? Yeah, why not? I don't think I want a starfisher. I don't think we need one. Strongholds?
Nah, we don't need that. I do.
Surface lakes and villages, though, we'll definitely have. Terrains. Standard terrain. Weather. We can just do... Since it's going to be a desert biome anyway, we'll just do no weather.
The derpy poison darts, what that was.
Are you guys shooting darts at each other?
Not exactly.
Those are all modifiers. These are all modifiers. These are all modifiers. You know what? Ouch. I'm going to have, just to make sure that we're cool. Ooh, he has to do some, yeah, I don't know who's doing that. Interesting, though. That's what? Pretty cool. You know how, your brother might be reading the liquid dictionary for what types of liquids you can place in the world in lieu of water?
Yeah.
One of them is steam block.
Yep.
That's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
You can have molten gold. That is awesome.
You can basically have anything that has a block ID, regardless of, unless a mod says no.
That's awesome.
And I highly doubt any mod is currently saying no.
Right. So I'm just going to grab stone block and water block, because we want to make sure that we don't get something that's unusual. I have to find where water block is. Lava.
Getting these look a little weird. At least on the server. They don't go horizontal, and then they turn back to direction they're flying.
And just remember, the standard terrain, that's the modifier. So stone block, water block, standard terrain should give us a pretty normal age. So I think that's everything we need. Desert biome, single biome, normal moon, twinkling stars, normal sun, normal lighting, caves, ravines, deep lakes, all kinds of cool stuff. And then finally we have no weather and the stone, water, standard terrain. Does that sound like a good plan, Zorn?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
For everyone asking if you could pump the steam, you could, but most of the steam would wind up on the top of the world, so since it flows up.
All right, I'm really hoping that this works correctly. I'm using mostly my resources for it. I really only cheated in the pages. Alright, so we've got a digger book here. I've got a pre-travel checklist to do. I always like to make sure I have a link book home, because that's pretty much crucial. Got that. And I've got some stuff, and I've got some other things. So let's do it. Digger, I've got a link book to the overworld, I've got my notebook. Probably get rid of this normal stars thing in a bit, but that's fine. And then once I'm confirming that this digger age turned out well, I will... Anti-PvP is a page. That sounds interesting.
Oh, he actually added that?
Did he? That sounds cool. I don't know. We have to ask him if that's working or not. I know he was talking about it.
Yeah.
Enough Miscraft spoilers. Wahaha. Here goes. Warning.
Did you go?
Oh. Oh, cool. It adds my name to the book as the author. Here goes.
Oh, dear. Now we can see whose fault it was for a world.
Yeah. Now, I did do normal sun, so it's okay that it's, like, nighttime here, because I didn't make this an eternal day age. But we definitely got, like, a pretty single-looking thing, and we don't have, like, poison effects, so I think the age is stable. There's a village in the distance.
Achievement get, desert.
So I guess that means that's a biomes of plenty desert?
Not necessarily.
Oh, okay. I mean, it looks pretty vanilla.
Yeah, I think it is.
It might be a vanilla desert. I don't see those little mini cacti.
Yeah, I see a creeper.
Cool.
And lag.
This way is just not, like, terribly annoying with rain and stuff. Like, you know. But I'm not doing Eternal Day, because I think that would be a little cheaty for solar generation. Like, this will be a proper age with proper stuff going on. So I think the home point of this age, Soren, should be our workshop.
I'm lagging.
Are you? I see monsters spawning. That can't be good. And they're pathfinding to us, incoming lag.
I know, what about Villager? Stupid.
He trades a fake essence crystal for a copper nugget. I don't know what either of those things are.
A copper nugget? You know what that is?
I don't know what a fake essence crystal is.
Obviously, an essence crystal that's fake.
Clearly. How did I not know that?
I don't know.
I'm not that smart. These villagers are panicking, dude. They need to calm down.
Where is this? Hey, I found oil.
You found oil?
Oil, right next to the book.
Nice.
Ooh, that's oil.
That's what I should have done, is I should have made it a desert oil field biome.
I like these cacti.
Oh, do you?
What is that?
What's what?
It's like a tree cactus is what it is. It's like a smiley face, really.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm going to say this is a smiley face cactus.
I want to see.
Alright, I'm going to run from the creeper face.
Alright guys, so how about we place down the link book home and get out of here, and then we'll come back when it's maybe not terribly scary at nighttime.
The moon is moving, right?
Yeah, it definitely is.
Okay.
It was like evening, and it was still a little bit light out when we landed here, and now it's totally dark.
Yeah, it is.
Cool. Alright guys, we'll be back in a few once a little bit of time has passed, and I deal with my health issues. Alright guys, we are back, and as you can see, I built a little nice entry welcome area in the Workshop Digger Nexus area. First rule that I just placed here is don't put a quarry right near spawn, and I'm starting to build out my first little area just to protect us. Morvi joined us. What's up, Morvi?
Not too much, just checking out what you're doing here.
Alright, so you want to be responsible for the welcoming area?
Yeah, I can definitely take a crack once I know what kind of dimensions and style to go for of making things pretty.
Yeah, I don't know what dimensions and style I want. What I'm basically thinking is, like, walk out, you know, and then, like, you know, some kind of room here that's just like a greeting. And then maybe off to the right we could have a travel room where we could have people put their books to their houses. But I don't really want people to have
to go. Where did the pig with the fez come from?
What's that? Oh, it's someone.
Oink.
Oh, it's like, pig with the fez? What?
Watch, Morby.
Oh. Yeah. I apparently...
Yeah.
Dire wolf is an Enderman. This is wrong. Oh god, Sorn. I will hit you. I will.
My favorite is this one.
Morby.
You're scaring me! They're scared.
I have a better one. He's adorable.
He is adorable. All right, so walk out, like, maybe off to the side. I don't know, do I want like a little welcome area, or do I want like the just like the first thing you walk into is a big machine workshop so you can immediately access it without having to travel too far? I don't know.
I know what the pretty answer is, but yeah. It probably doesn't mesh with
Well, I guess if people don't want to have to travel too far to the workshop, then they can just create a linking book to the actual workshop area of it. So, like, maybe a room here that's welcome area, a room off to the side that's a portal area just for people to travel and put their books in, and then, like, a big room right beyond the welcome area that's going to be, like, the machine room. And then underground we can have power and such, Soren, and all that, and then et cetera, et cetera. That's not the plan?
Yeah.
And you got a cat on your head.
I do.
Cool. Yeah. All right, we'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back. So what I'm doing, heading to Digger, and I'm placing down a Magnum Torch. This is another extra utilities gadget. And boom. That should prevent mob spawns in a 64-block radius, I think. Any new ones, at least.
Yep.
Cool. All right, so I'm going to start building out the workshop, Soren. What do you think? You want to go like 21 by 21, something like that, for a nice large inside area, or do you want to go...
Actually...
Is that a fake bat?
No, it's an actual player. You can't fly.
Okay.
Hold on for a second.
Let's get the dimensions mapped out, and then we'll be back. All right, guys, we are back. You can see progress is being made here. So you decided, Soren, that each corner will have different mod-related machines and such?
Yep.
So this will be like the industrial craft corner, and there'll be a bunch of industrial craft machines. You can walk up and be like, oh, yeah, cool stuff. I do like this design, actually, because it does allow you to like walk up and access all the machines pretty easily.
Yep. And you don't have to walk across a entire area and just walk to the center. It's like, all right, I'm going to be over there and over there.
Yeah, I like it. And we could even have some machines like lining the center walls here, like right along here.
Indeed.
If we needed to. For like those mods that don't have enough machines to fill a corner.
Yeah.
That would work. Okay. I like it.
We can always make an underground area for like energy or messy looking.
Right.
Like cobble gems.
Oh, good news. I got a Ender Pearl.
Ooh.
Yeah. Bad news, we're really low on wood.
Yeah, we are. Actually, these are 9x9s, they're just separated.
How'd you get in there?
If I extended that, this is a 9x9.
Okay, that. You. Ooh, there was a couple more enderpearls, I don't know where they came from. That.
What you doing, man?
I am currently working on getting another ender tank.
Did I happen to die just now?
No.
I didn't see a message about it.
You're actually not logged in.
Yeah, well, it's because I was getting attacked by a little imp thing, and then my client did the freeze-up thing, so...
Well, it just said you left. You didn't die.
Ah, good. Yellow flowers.
Does anyone happen to know the name of the function it is that does the lighting updates?
No.
I think I just found it, so never mind.
Are you going to intervene?
He might.
Ta-da! I am deleting it.
Alright, we have infinite lava at our main base, Orn. And by infinite, I mean sort of infinite.
Infinite in terms of where our pump is?
Yeah.
All right.
While you guys get to building the workshop here, I'm going to get a couple basic machines going from Industrial Craft before we have to wrap up the episode.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm going to make a computer. I'm going to make a turtle.
Okay, so we're probably gonna want some redstone. Maybe.
Where is glass in this assortment? We have it?
I don't know that we necessarily have a good amount of glass laying around.
Alright.
Alright, so let's see what's involved here. Because industrial craft, guys, changed quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Some things are not done being changed, I don't think. Player can probably correct me on that if I'm wrong. But, oh, see, there's refined iron plates now. But I can still go with basic machine casing, which is 8 refined iron plates. Refined iron plates come from a refined iron and a forge hammer. Forge hammer is refined iron and sticks. Okay, that's cool. I'm going to need quite a bit of this stuff.
Right.
I'm just going to get like half a stack of refined iron. That should be a good start.
Okay. And welcome people to join the
stream. Oh boy. Now I have to get cutters for copper plates. Oh boy.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
If you want wires, yeah, you have to use wire cutters. You can automate it later, but the first steps you'll need tools.
Alright, I hope you're not lying about automating later.
Yeah, you use the compressor and the metal former later on.
Yeah.
Alright, cool. Alright guys, we'll be back in a minute once this refined iron cooks up. Alright, we're back, so let's try this nifty stuff out. So I guess first off I'll need to make a hammer so that I can make these awesome plates. And it's only gotten a certain number of uses, so keep that in mind. And then we need a cutter, which is refined iron and iron. So iron and refined iron? That looks cool. So if I want to get some... Let's get like 10, let's say. 10 copper plates. And then I can cut that into 20 insulated cabling. Or uninsulated, that is. So there we go. That wasn't so bad. Okay.
Yeah.
That's not terrible. Generator. Basic machine casing. Okay. Basic machine casing, furnace, and a battery. What's the deal with batteries? Let's find out. Probably have to look up the empty battery recipe, I would imagine. Okay, I need redstone, copper cable, and tin item casing, which is a tin plate used on the hammer, which is probably tin. Okay, that's not too bad either. I'll go with 8 of these for now.
I used to have a couple gems that were 5x5x5, so I'm going to try to make that again. Actually, no, they're 3x3x3s. The wall will be counted, but...
Alright, I have our first generator.
Cool.
That wasn't terrible.
It was, oh my god, awful.
Oh, so terrible. Alright, next up I want to make an extractor just so I can start working on the sticky resin. And then we'll get to wrapping up the episode, and from there, etc., etc. So electronic circuit is same recipe as before, that's not so bad. Soren, actually, no, wait, let's see. Let's see if I'm lying or not.
Probably are.
Yeah, I am.
I think it would be. It's been so long since I made an automatic, or a manual automatic cobble gem.
I need a little bit more wood.
There should be some in the wood chest.
There is, thank you.
Thank him. He had 53 on him. So, water will flow down from here. Let me go get me 2 water buckets.
Is Zam that your sidekick now?
Yeah, it's like a hierarchy of sidekicks right now.
Okay, fair enough.
Sidekick.
The sidekick of a sidekick of a sidekick.
Yep.
Alright, that time it definitely didn't work. Shift clicking the question mark doesn't seem to always work anymore.
Nice.
Perfect.
Yes. All right. For now, I guess I'll start putting this in the age here. If we have to move these machines, it's cool, Soren. But I'm gonna start by just putting things randomly, because I want to get this started up.
I'm just working on cobblegen.
Okay. Oh, cool. Cobblegen.
All right. So place 1 water in between the turtle and the cobblestone block there. The other one. The corner. And then we'll need another water in this corner.
How many diamonds are you using to make this cobble gem?
Right now just 6.
Oh, my diamonds.
6 diamonds for a cobble gem?
Because we don't have any block riggers.
6 diamonds. Yes we do.
Seriously?
Okay. Block record that, you know, you can actually maintain right now. Right.
Probably not.
Yeah.
Because AE has a block breaker. I guess we couldn't.
Yeah, but you need power and you need the net. So.
Well, if you gave me a few minutes, I probably could have managed it.
This will just be break, break, break.
All right, guys. So as you can see, there's a lot of new mechanics to Industrial Craft. Actually, a lot of things are changing. I'm pretty excited to try it out. There's like new blocks, new generators, like the radioisotope thermoelectric generator, semi-fluid generator. There's new machines, metal formal, thermal centrifuge, all kinds of stuff. And I don't think they're quite anywhere near done. I think it's going to be like a lot of changes. I still have to find out from Player. Player, what's the ore washing plant do? Because I noticed you can get... Yeah, it basically gives you, like, is it just a method to get that stone dust stuff? Because you get, like, crushed ore, and then you get purified crushed ore. And when you purify it, you get stone dust. But it doesn't give you any more of the ore. So you still can only get two times, as far as I could tell. I don't know. We'll figure it out. All right, guys. For now, it increases the yield and rare materials. Okay, cool. All right, for now, we do have to wrap up the episode. So Direwolf 20 signing off episode 4. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll be back next episode with more work on the workshop. And don't worry, cobblestone's obviously just a temporary thing until we have a lot of smooth stone production, and then we'll turn it into bricks or something nice looking. Soren, you just love the multiple torches in one block thing, don't you?
Maybe.
I just noticed you put that everywhere.
Yes, put that in Serena.
Nice. All right, guys. Take it easy.